Has anyone here ever seen the risen Christ? Our faith in the risen Christ is challenged every single day within our culture, just like it was for Thomas. Thomas was a lot like us, better visual and kinesthetic learners. Don't just tell me, show me. The same challenge is given to us as a church community. The credibility of our church and the credibility of our lives here at Christ the Servant depends on our ability not just to tell people about the risen Lord, but to show the presence of the risen Lord within our thoughts, words, and actions. So how does Jesus appear in the world today? We want to see it, we want to feel it, we want to know it, and we want to walk with it. And Jesus promised that he would send his Spirit. And he would send his Spirit, but his Spirit needs a body. So where is that body? Right here. Right here, each of us, you and me, as a community of faith, the community of Christ the Servant, anointed, every single one of you, anointed in your own baptism, become bearers of the absent physical body of Christ. You become bearers of God's Spirit, of Christ's Spirit, sent out to be the hands and the feet and the heart of Christ. You and me, imagine what we are called to be and the responsibility we have in being the body of Christ. And somehow we seem to separate that so many times between this hour of the week and the other hours of our week. This is how Jesus appears in the world today. We can talk about it, but to those we live with every day, they need to see it, feel it, know it, sense it, as we walk through the doors. Just as Jesus walked through the doors of the upper room. So Easter just keeps happening. Easter just keeps on coming. The risen Christ walking through the locked doors of the upper room in the gospel today. Sometimes walking through the door of the locked down churches, the locked down minds, and the locked down hearts. So what do people see? When people look at us as the community of Christ the Servant, when they look at us as those who proclaim to be Christians, what do they see? Do they see the ugliness of our own scars and of our own wounded hands and feet and hearts? Or do they see the wounded hands, feet, and hearts of a self-giving, loving people who live their lives in faithfulness to that gospel each and every day? Do they see and touch the very presence of Christ in each and every one of us as the body of Christ? As bearers of God's compassion. And on this Sunday, as bearers of God's mercy, bearers of God's tenderness and God's consolation, to those in the world that touch the body and the spirit of our lives, who come into contact with us each and every day, Do we enable them through us to touch Christ's mercy, to discover Christ's mercy, to find Christ's mercy with their own hands? Just as Thomas was told to put his hands into the Lord's, fingers into the Lord's wounds, and his hand into his side. Are we there and present with that love and that care and that mercy and that forgiveness, entering into the lives of people who many times are despairing? And in return, do we allow the misery of others to touch our hearts so that as we, as the body of Christ, become the living body of Christ's mercy in this world? The responsibility is a tremendous one. The gift given to us of the Spirit is a tremendous one. Easter just keeps on coming, day after day after day. God bless you.